We gotta talk about his sense of urgency.
We are completely down. This is him.
He barely walks.
I better be glad I didn't have my phone turned down.
Yeah, you're right, yeah, Greg. True. Well, I go back to this again, though. Is this a sign? You have to always look at that.
Oh, no.
Is it a sign?
Ooh, Rick.
That the attempt to bring Cupid or Coaster back is the wrong thing to do. I mean,
I think it's just kind of weird power surge.
What is funny is we went through all this.
Power surge happens and takes away our attempt to play a song and then gives it back to us when we're done.
Of course, I emailed him and said, hey,
well,
that's just some kind
of way back. Why don't we check and see if we're back?
Yeah, we're back.
We are back.
We are.
Yeah. Speedy, you have to tell your story because the people, when they left us, you just said the guy heard of your dad's doctor. And I just thought it was a person that had heard of the dad.
When did it blink? Was it when we were playing it?
Think so.
We just started.
Did we ever get started?
So we built it up.
Well, y'all just take our word for it.
Because I was enjoying it. We were all enjoying it. And all of a sudden we looked
by ourselves.
Yeah, I thought somebody was in the hall.
We might as well have taken the link and gotten our car and drove around.
Yes. Yes. 100%. It was like, all right, guys, check out this song. And that is it.
Oh, and we're all in here like, yeah, that's pretty good.
Oh, wow.
What would y'all do if
what
would you do if we came back and we tried to play a little clip of it again and it went out again?
Oh, let's try.
I've already heard the message, but if y'all want to try it again.
I think we try it again.
Oh, you realize that?
I want to know how much they heard. We're going to have to find out.
How about none?
I don't think they heard. But when did it leave?
We'll ask you when we come back. More Rick and Bubba next.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
That sings. Yeah. Yeah. You thought for a while, and I did too. Man, his voice is just as good as Steve's. There's nobody that was as good as Steve. And he's performing here. This is them performing "Don't Stop Believing." Now, don't get me wrong. He's still good.
Yeah, I mean, he's not Steve Perry.
No, now one good thing for me, and I talked to Greg and Hobie about this. You know how I can't watch live award shows. I can, but for some reason I can watch bands perform live, which is weird. I don't know why.
Well, because usually they pull it off. That's why. Yeah. But here's the other thing: what you don't want to see them is get up and accept an award. You're fine seeing them do what they do well.
Yeah.
But here's the problem: I'm glad you didn't hear this. I tried to find videos of it, and a lot of people just had their phones. Mm-hmm. You can, Speedy, do you not want me to tell you?
What?
There were people saying, hey, maybe Steve's going to come out, man, come on. Mm-hmm. And they're the whole time they think he's still going to come out and sing a song with him. And it doesn't happen. You hear him talking, you think he's going to come out? I think he will. And so I hate that.
Well, the fact that they let the Filipino come out at all would tell you he's not, because the Filipino wasn't even inducted.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? The fact that he sang it all. You knew he wouldn't come.
Yeah, and now one good thing is they never showed after the acceptance.
And I should refer to him as the Filipino. I just don't remember.
Right. After the acceptance speech.
We're just calling him the Filipino.
Maybe we should learn his name.
Steve Perry left.
Mm-hmm.
He got off the stage, and the guys got grabbed their guitars and everything. And then once that happened, they didn't show Steve anymore, which was good. I didn't want him sitting over on still watching something.
No,
you know, I'd have been really uncomfortable.
If you ever wondered what Greg Raleigh sounded like before Steve Perry came in.
I like their opinion.
And and then he gradually would let.
Open my eyes to a new kind of way.
That was Journey before Steve Perry.
And then he was still in it, but he would just sing parts.
That you said.
So this is the guy that was singing to begin with.
Are you feeling
the guy who cashed out?
You feeling that way?
What is it?
Or am I just
now? Listen, then he'll let Steve come in.
Am I just a fool?
Wait, that's not
the summer's gone.
Wow.
Standing by the line.
He's letting everybody know I'm about to leave.
Yeah.
And then he comes back.
It's a feeling.
So he's getting us ready. He's about to make transition.
You're feeling that way too. Or am I just a fool? A new road's waiting. You touch my life. Oh.
So that was,
oh,
that was
God, they do it.
Yeah, that was them.
And
I'm mad at you for cutting that off.
Greg Raleigh also sang Black Magic Woman in Santana. Him and Neil Sean were in Santana when they were teenagers.
Forgot about that, too.
And he's the one that sings Black Magic Woman.
Do you know I had a Neil Sean moment backstage talking to him with Ryan Greenwood?
Is that when Bad English was on tour? We all got to go meet Sam, or was that
no.
it?
No. Yeah. It's when, actually, it was the time I got burned on the arm.
Oh, the little fella.
And it still has not spun. Speedy here, the real Greg Burgess, Helmsy. Eddie Van Adler has RBTV. Have a two-putt secure, and don't be mad with me, earning their degree in common sense from Rick and Bubba University. We welcome back for a brand new hour. Put your hands together. Number 12 on his jersey. Here by the City Hall.
Okay, here. Yeah. Yep.
Once you find the den, it's pretty easy.
The pest control guys pull 5 snakes from hiding in less than an hour.
Think it's great that they're not in my house and they're there, right?
But today's find doesn't truly tell the hell Angie Whitley has been living through.
I hate that she's going through this.
That's where we found the 2 today.
The evidence of that lurks in her basement, now torn apart and littered with snake traps.
Sorry, Bob.
I'll be upstairs.
As a nurse and a single mom, Whitley spent years renting a townhouse in order to save enough for a down payment for a new start.
It was clean, new carpet, new paint.
This split level in Oak Park Heights seemed like the perfect neighborhood for her 2 kids to grow up in. Several walkthroughs and an inspection yielded no trouble. But 45 minutes after closing on October 5th, plenty of it slithered in.
I brought my first sort of box in downstairs to my bedroom, and I found a snake. And one quickly turned into 3, 4, 5. Oh, God. Today, it's 6 months later, and I'm about now 95 snakes that I found inside my house.
Now you might as
That's
well say
95 inside.
You can see.
Minutes past the hour. Well, the power outage, or whatever it was, here at the studio station, so we apologize. That kind of messed your commercial breakup, too. We got back on time, but I don't know that you got closures in and out there, so we lost Denver there for a little while. So our apologies. Everything is resetting and rebooting, and we should be back to norm, we hope. So, looking at the email, Bubba, asking your question, did anybody, when did the people leave us? And they said, iHeartRadio, we did not get it, could not pick up what was going on. Tune in, we caught the last 5 seconds of the, or about 5 seconds of the song. let's see, Huntsville said, I drove at least 6 miles. Hoping to hear the song, but I had nothing but silence for 6 entire miles.
Here's an email that says, we heard the start of the phone, but no lyrics. I thought Will Smith had walked in the studio.
Did you say the start of the phone?
That's what he said. Yeah. I'm just reading.
Do you mean song?
Yeah, probably.
You know, and I love our audience. They're so skittish when it comes to us being ripped off the air. Some say, whatever affiliate, fill in the blank, they just took y'all off. They didn't want it to be played.
I know.
YouTube yanked you off, whatever. No, that's not what happened.
Yeah, I was about to say, the YouTube people, you know, they suffer from cancellation PTSD.
Right.
And their first thought was, well, they pulled you off for playing that song. I got that all through my email. So nobody got it. Nobody heard it.
No. We're back up now, though, right?
Testing 1, 2. I don't know. That song, I hate to say this to Stan, maybe we shouldn't play it.
And now here's another. We're dying to hear it, y'all. We haven't heard it. Y'all have.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard it.
It's actually pretty good.
Yeah, I mean,
distrust us is good.
If I was voting, I would say, yeah, it's a good song.
Yeah. Save My Dying Soul.
Yeah, right.
What?
Save My Dying Soul is the name of the song.
Should I play at least a little bit of it for the audience?
You can.
Yeah, I would. I'd just do it over.
What? Amateur.
I'm not going to play a lot of it.
Yeah, amateur songwriter.
One chorus.
We don't stay with
I'm going to
two
one chorus. No.
Two chorus.
It's too long. That's too much.
It's a great song.
Is that mine?
Yeah. No, that's me.
That's not it.
Am I playing the right song?
Wait a minute. That doesn't sound like it.
I like that one I just played.
That's so good, Rick.
Apparently that one's already a hit.
The room is spinning round and round. I can feel the walls coming down. Like deja vu, I've been here before. Watching you walk out the door. My love's a fire burning bright. A new morning, a new night. If I told you, would you turn and run? I'm so scared, drunk and numb. I know you're sleeping, I know it's late. Please forgive me, but this can't wait. My heart belongs to you. If you didn't love, will you save my dying soul? I know you're sleeping, I know it's late. Please forgive me, but this can't wait. My heart belongs to you. If you didn't love, will you save my dying soul? I feel too old to love.
So there you go. So there it is. We got that. Greg, hang yours over too. We'll be doing that one too. Yeah.
Look at him light up. Yeah. Did you see him light up?
Yeah, because
we got to vote on that.
Yeah, keep it or coaster on this one first. And you're judging the song. I don't know how much you heard us, but we're a song. The aspiring songwriter sent this. That is a person paid to do demos that is singing it. Mm-hmm. So keep it or coaster on the song.
They're pretty good too, though.
Yeah, oh, they are, of course. But we're not judging them because they probably have.
I know y'all are big on lyrics, the Burgess Boys. Y'all like the song?
Absolutely. Yeah, okay. It's not corny. It's not campy. It's not one inch deep.
Okay.
It was good.
Stan?
So, Stan, as far as your songwriting skills, buddy, you got a good hook on the chorus.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it was good. 866, We Be Big. Adler, how'd you like it?
I told you. Adler.
That's why nobody should email him.
It's good.
You're mad that it's good, aren't you?
Okay, I will say this. This is better than a lot of the ones that we've played before. It's not my style. I'm just going to say that. It's not my style. I wouldn't listen to it in my car by myself.
Sure, but I'm just talking about, is it a good song for people who do like that kind of music?
For people that like that kind of music, yeah, it's good.
Yeah, that's kind of where I was coming from.
Yeah, I like the power ballad part of it, you know.
Mm-hmm. It was a good song.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'd listen to that one.
Hi, Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster on what's the name of the song?
Kind of want to know how I can get it.
Save My Dying Soul?
Yes.
Hey, Keep It or Coaster on Save My Dying Soul.
Keep it.
All right, see there. Let's continue. 866, We Be Big, Keep It or Coaster.
Keep it.
Rick and Bubba's Show, Keep It or Coaster. Go ahead.
Yep.
They hung up. Hey, Rick and Bubba's Show, Keep It or Coaster.
I like it. Hey, I'm just going to let you know that I'm streaming you live on the TuneIn app.
We got it. Okay, good.
All right, Dan.
Like the song or not?
Keep It or Coaster.
Two thumbs up.
All right. Hey, Rick and Bubba's Show. Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
Like deja vu, that song is deja.
What did he say?
I want to say this to you, sir. Appreciate you trying to be funny, whatever, but that may have been the worst phone. Worst quality phone. And I can't think about what I'm saying because we've had some real turds. Okay? that was as bad a phone. You should take that phone back to wherever you got it,
Rick,
and demand that you get your money back.
Rick, I mean, heard Dixie cups with a string on it that sounded better.
Right. Yeah. I'm talking about you going there mad. I mean, I'd go in there angry. Yeah. Say, I tell you what, if y'all can't give me a phone that sounds any better than this, did I just pay $900 for this thing? Hey, Rick and Bubba's Show, Keep It or Coaster.
Keep it.
Mm-hmm. All right, so still 100% on that. Hi, Rick and Bubba's Show, Keep It or Coaster. Go ahead.
Keep it.
All right, let's see. Rick and Bubba's Show, Keep It or Coaster. Go ahead.
Keep it.
Okay, so there it is.
I think the jury's in on that one.
There you go, Stan.
Yeah. The audience has saved that dying soul.
All right, Greg has one he wants to bring, too, to the table. Greg, tell us about one you got.
I'm not sure which cut it is.
I don't know what cut it is.
Okay.
Mike's been trying to get me this, and for some reason we were having trouble getting
it delivered
here.
A band called
Tremaine. Mm-hmm. It's country. And
serious.
Mike's been trying to send it, and then it never came, but I finally, the other week. I don't know about the mail here, but
I may
end up with about three or four of them before it's over.
Is this the tracks right?
It looks that way, and I don't know what cut do we play.
Well, I'm not sure.
I'm going to ask the guys.
I'm sure they're all good.
Listen, guys.
I thought you screened this.
I haven't had a chance. I don't have a CD player.
Greg.
That's true. Nobody does anymore.
That technology.
All right, listen. Would y'all rather hear?
I used to have one in my truck.
Do y'all want me to spin The Lady I Love?
Something Grooving, Muscle Shoals Music Man.
Hang on, I may have it.
When You Break My Heart, Make the Right Move, Gonna Need a Little Help.
Wow.
Dixie in the Moonlight.
Hmm. Quite a lot. The Lady I Love, I think is what. Yeah.
What cut is that, Rick?
That's cut one.
You go with that one.
Yeah, I'd say when in doubt, go with cut one.
Okay.
Because that's the one they're going to try to hook you on.
Okay.
All right, CD 2 is ready.
CD 2?
Yeah.
All right, so Greg, who
Tremaine.
Is this? Tremaine. All right, this is another Keep It or Coaster. So Stan Song.
Working through gotta keep
they've it. They've won state awards and for country group.
Who are you? I don't even know who you are.
I'm just telling you,
right.
I'm reading the information.
Okay, all right, so
don't taint the audience. Just let them hear
it. Just be quiet. You've done enough. All right, here it is. Keep It or Coaster. Watch Adler's face. Never take your eye off Adler.
You sang this, Greg?
I would like to.
Got kind of a Jimmy Buffett feel.
It does.
There's Adler on guitar.
Yeah, there he is. Everybody likes a good little guitar run.
Mm-hmm. Lady I Love by Tremaine.
Yeah. I think you're right. It has a little Jimmy Buffett feel.
All right, so Lady I Love by Tremaine. Is it germane to know Tremaine?
Yes, it is.
All right, so let's
The audience will decide.
The audience will decide. Hello, Rick and Bubba Show. Keep It or Coaster, Tremaine, the lady I love.
Coaster.
All right. Hi, Rick and Bubba Show. Keep It or Coaster.
Coast
it. My kid's too young to appreciate it.
The audience is turned.
My kid's too young.
Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
Let's coast for that one.
Okay. Well, you know, it's why we do it. I mean, hey, Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
I went off the air on the wrong song.
That's a great.
Now that's clever. That's clever.
You should call more, sir.
Greg, yeah. I just ain't getting you Talladega tickets.
Hey, Rick and Bubba Show. I bet he could though. Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
Hey, it's got an old school flavor to it. I really like it. Keep it.
Okay, right. There you go.
It depends. You got to reach the right audience.
Hey, Keep It or Coaster. Go ahead.
Keep it.
Okay.
Right. Coming back.
Make it a
coming
comeback.
Back. Strong.
Hey,
throw that kid's vote out.
Adler keeps voting on the TV
that's
screen.
So good. Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
The Lady I Love is the Song I Hate, Coaster.
Okay. Y'all ain't got to get cute.
Yeah. Hey, Rick, I like it getting cute. Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, go ahead.
What'd you promise them, girl?
Really?
No, I just want to get
keep
a fair
it,
shake.
And play it again.
Okay, there's a member of the band. All right, so all right, let's.
I finally got it.
Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster. Lost that one. Hey, Rick and Bubba Show, Keep It or Coaster.
Keep it.
Oh, Coast It, man. That was awful.
Okay. Well, all right. So that one didn't do as well. So Tremaine, Lady I Love, Coaster. Save My Dying Soul by Stan. What's his last name? Troop? The songwriter.
Right.
Keep It.
Yep.
So there it is.
The audience has spoken.
The audience has spoken. One Keep It, one Coaster. Greg, it's all right.
No, look, hey, we just deliver it out there and let the audience deal with it.
Well, I know.
You're going to email him and let him know?
We'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
One that just came out now.
A few hundred more outside.
Hundreds.
In the snake world, this is up there.
Angie Whitley now knows a garter snake den is somewhere under her property, which sits close to a marsh.
Water creates a big void underneath the foundation. That's where the corner of her house is.
The perfect location for a reptile attracted to heat and to each other.
They were in their little ball.
Whitley has spent more than $13,000 herself trying to rid her family of the problem,
Bubba.
Ripping up her finished basement to tightly seal off any potential cracks.
If you can fit a pencil through,
they could fit through.
And pumping out 40 gallons of water from a large hole she found in the foundation.
We really thought that that was the problem.
Still, the spring has brought the snakes back.
There's a lot of it.
Adams Pest Control has now donated their services to try to locate the snake den.
A lot of sleepless nights.
Well, Whitley now sleeps upstairs on the couch and stays out of the basement.
Bump in the road that I'm not quite sure how to solve yet.
She's upset, y'all.
Desperate for relief and for this sickening puzzle to be solved once and for all.
Mm. We're going to get it. It will be done.
Liz Collin, WCCO 4 News.
Yes, burn it to the ground.
Good gracious. 95. Rick,
one answer here. Moab. Good night.
Y'all, I was listening to the numbers they were tallying up, and we got to around 300.
Golly, y'all.
Bubba.
At least they're garter snakes, you know, but still.
And wads. You see them in there, wads. Wads of snakes.
In my mind, that's exactly what hell will look like. You know what?
Good night. Bubba, they
were
everywhere.
That's the location.
They were everywhere.
Oh, I know.
Work so hard to get you a house. You can't have nothing. You can't even have a split level.
I'd move right out of that baby. Let the lawyers handle it. You know.
Well, what I would do would, you know, get somebody to accidentally burn it to the ground. So at least I've got insurance. You know what I mean?
No, that's awful.
That many in one place. Good.
Did you say 95 just inside?
Just inside. And the guy used the word hundreds outside. That's why I got to my 300 point. I figure hundreds is a couple hundred. And I've added the 95 inside and then five that just came from somewhere. I'm at 300. 300 garter snakes.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
He gave me his 300.
I mean.
That's a lot of snakes.
Good gracious.
That's a ton. I don't care.
Well, if it bites you, you'd like old briar snakes.
How about that? I don't like briars.
I don't like the way they move.
I don't want to be bit by
anything, that many of anything in my house.
I don't want to be bit by anything with teeth. Bottom line.
Thank you, Rick.
I don't want to be bit by any animal of any kind. Really, people. I don't want people bite me either.
No, Rick. That's a
anything with teeth biting. Well, you just like old briar scratch. You know, they bite you. You ain't going to poison you.
I don't want to be bit by a slithering, cursed animal.
No.
I don't care whether it shoots venom in or not. I mean, Rick, that's a nice little consolation, but I didn't like being bit by it.
Yeah, Rick. I mean, we're talking about an animal that Satan chose to bring down all of humanity. You know, the whole creation. Good night.
Good. Just out slithering on its old cursed stomach.
Well, I mean, hey, snakes don't bother you if you don't bother them.
Well, tell that to the 300 moving in my trial level.
I wish I had my 12 gauge right now next to me. Mm-hmm. Just on the whole concept.
Like if somehow right now somebody would just say God has decided to rid the earth of snakes, I'd say hallelujah.
I know it.
Every single one.
I might raise my arms.
I wish everybody had one as a pet would find it dead today. Every one of them. Every little terrarium, every little cage, every little box you got them in, you went over and they're just dead as a wedge. Every single one of them. Eradicated from all existence.
Ireland gets by. Isn't it Ireland that doesn't have any snakes?
Well, we say.
They claim.
That's one of those things people say.
Well, I mean, they get along fine.
They do. It's, yeah, Jamaica, I don't think, has any.
No, really? They don't.
That's really? Am I making that up?
No, that's what they told us when we stopped there.
Jamaica
on Rick
has no snakes. Mm-mm.
Really?
No, no snakes, Mom.
There were holes everywhere big enough to fall into, and the locals told us it was mongoose holes.
Mongoose rid of them.
The mongoose get rid of them. They
Buffalo soldier.
Huh.
We got no snakes.
Everybody remembers Ricky Ticky Tavy.
We have a bunch of... The holes in the ground, though, where the things that rid us of snakes have been burned.
Break your ankle.
But that's fine.
Rick,
a broken ankle ain't as bad as a snake bite.
Well, and
there's
funny,
your snake update, Rick.
Funny that, you know, we're talking about golf.
Snake update. Snake update. I'll take spiders all day over snakes. Now you're on spiders.
I don't like them.
They bite too, Rick.
I don't want to be bit by any animal.
I don't want them on me, but I feel like I can handle that situation better than old no shoulders.
Spider or roach to crawl over you?
Roach.
I got to go roach.
Really?
I may go spider.
Either one.
We'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
Swing,
7 minutes to the top of the hour. Would that have been a keeper or a coaster if nobody ever heard of John Anderson?
It'd have been a keeper for me. I like him. That's a toe tapper.
It's almost like a comedy song.
I know, but it's funny. You know what it reminds me of a little bit? Zach Tyson with his he paints such a great picture of what everybody's doing. You can see.
Oh yeah. I wonder why somebody's eating chocolate pie before the chicken's ready.
There I was.
Couldn't wait.
They're
sitting on front porch and I'm flying. A2B.com/radio. Hey, if you have got trucks rolling and they've got a fleet card or you use a fleet card, why in the world would their fuel card only give them discounts at certain locations?
Why?
It's time for you to make the move to A2B.com/radio. Go there. You'll find out everything that you need to know. If Visa is accepted, the A2B.com/radio fuel card will be accepted, and you will get discounts anywhere you fill up. The only no's you have, no setup fee, no transaction fee, no monthly fee, no late payment fees, no over the limit, no gallon limits to the amount of discounted fuel. And when you use this card and you pay on time, you start getting some discounts, and you get a $50 credit when you use the zero fee card. That's for a limited time. So go to the letter A, and then the word two, A2B.com/radio for a $50 credit, or go to rickandbubba.com, find that link there under the sponsors, and put this fuel card to work for your fleet. All right, so there we go. All right, so Bubba, what's going on with tennis? Can you help me with the state of tennis?
You know,
it's just every time we do a story, there's something negative going on with tennis.
Well, Rick, Victoria Azarenka, who I've seen play before at the U.S. Open, former number one women's player in the world, shocked fans on Sunday when she abruptly left the court during the middle of a match at the Miami Open, playing against a 16-year-old competitor. Azarenka informed the chair umpire that she was done and stormed off the court in the second set as the teenager led 6-2, 3-0.
No, that's it.
Yeah, call for the physio, okay? Let me give you 1 second. Virtually, it's three games to love.
So Azarenka is calling the physio to come on out, said she wants to stop, so she's calling the match.
Wow. Oh, that's good.
Wow.
That would be a competitor.
This is a stunning turn of events. Victoria Azarenka just shook the umpire's hand, and she is leaving the court. And I'm assuming that she's done.
That is absolutely disrespectful. That is terrible behavior from such a mature player. You can understand that she is not happy at all with the way she's playing.
You know, the sad part of that, if I'm this girl who's playing, I'm like, thank goodness I moved to the next round. I'm off.
Yeah.
I can move and save myself here a little bit. But if you're a fan and you've paid big bucks for these tickets, and then your performance was just cut short, you know, and that's not good.
This is nothing to do with what we're talking about as far as the sport or anything. I'm making a straight up statement right now because I'm seeing it happen. When did quitting become embraced?
Yeah,
I mean, it's now like I quit, I give up. Everybody's being mean to me. This is the things I keep hearing now, and especially
you see people retire in tennis from time to time, but usually it's because of an injury.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Usually they'll
I'm,
take.
Yeah, I'm not a, talking about that.
They'll take an injury timeout, and you know the medical people will come out, look them over, and then they will inform the chair they're not going to.
You know how? For instance, remember at one time in our country and in the world, one of the greatest moments that we embraced. Do you remember this thing? When it was some marathon runner that blew up their foot or their knee or something, and their daddy like went out there and got their shoulder underneath them and helped them, and the guy finished the race.
Right.
Had every reason in the world to quit and just stop, and he said, "Well, no, I'm going to finish the race. I realize I'm not going to win it. I am injured." This would even been an excuse. Now I just quit competition if I'm not playing well. I quit competition if I think somebody's saying something mean from the stands. I quit competition. It's just too much for me. It's just too much pressure. I'm just having a bad day. I mean, there was a time when that was considered to be repulsive behavior.
Do we know anything else
about it? And now we're just like, okay, good, fine.
Why, to your point, Rick, I think we've discussed this started happening more and more, it seems like, when Simone Biles did that in the Olympics. Right. That's been the forefront of this conversation. Yep. Then we've had Osaka do similar things. This particular athlete had an incident a week and a half ago where she has lost the first set, which is normal in tennis. It's 2-2 in the second, and deuce in this game, and starts balling. This is her. This is the same person 2 weeks ago, starts crying on the court. I had never seen this before. Can't even serve. She goes minutes with crying. The chair umpire has to get out of the chair, go console her. Meanwhile, the number 17th ranked player who is beating her, and this is a pivotal point of the match, is going, hey, what? We can't just stop in the middle of this.
Because you're crying.
And I mean, look, bent over crying.
Come on.
The same person.
But
is this injury driven though? She's got a lot of tape on her right arm.
She's always struggled with injuries. I don't think it is. I think honestly, and she may just be leaning on this too. Okay. She's from Belarus. She's got a lot of family over in Ukraine and Russia, friends. And I think this is the emotional part that she's leaning on. True or not, I don't know. I don't know the inner workings of Azarenka. But this is 2 weeks in a row where this has happened.
I don't even have a problem with having compassion for people, but when do we start applauding it?
I know.
You know? We don't applaud it.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.
Hey, thanks for watching Rick and Bubba live on YouTube.
We're here live at 5 with a kickoff hour bright and early Monday through Friday.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell for notifications on our YouTube channel.
And catch a commercial-free best of hour on Blaze TV every day.
Rick and Bubba, it's must-see TV.
Or radio.
Well, yeah.
Rick and Bubba.
Waking on the blubber. Rick and Bubba, Rick.